of cesarean delivery include patient apprehension of labor pain, patient to have a single childbirth, delay in childbirth, and then finally the social influence. Discussion. Cesarean section rate has strikingly increased from 3.8 in 1988 to 39.3 in the year 2008 in China, 11.3 in the countryside, and 64.1% in the city. Absolute indication for EPS was massive hemorrhage, previous cesarean section, uterine otony, and the placenta previa related to placenta accreta, placenta inferiata. We observed cesarean section hysterectomy occupied the larger space for treatment of EPS than vaginal delivery hysterectomy. In our study, we identified the significant risk factors for emergency peripartum hysterectomy by previous cesarean section, placenta previa mainly related to placenta accreta, placenta procreata, otony uterus, scar pregnancy, broad ligament hematoma, polyhydramnios, and metronome age, advanced metronome age. In these preventive methods, there were almost 394 cases. We divided into cases as a part of emergency peripartum hysterectomy and control group. In this control group, we observed the surgical procedure or medical procedure to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. In the control group, we observed uterine packing, uterovaginal packing, bleed breast suture, placental bed suture with figure of 8 had prevented postpartum hemorrhage and prevented further emergency peripartum hysterectomy. However, those who failed with this treatment got emergency peripartum hysterectomy to save mother's life. After post-operative emergency peripartum hysterectomy, maternal complications included hemorrhagic shock, DIC, needed ICU, ventilator, fever, hypoalbuminemia, paralytic ureas, urinary bladder repair, incisional hernia, heart failure, and acute respiratory distress syndrome from severe preeclampsia. After reviewing all the histopathology of the uterus, we observed placenta accreta was the main leading cause of emergency peripartum hysterectomy, leading to massive hemorrhage and required for postpartum hemorrhage treatment. Limitation of my study, it is a retrospective nature, data collection from a single center covering small area of Chongqing city. We also could not verify some variables such as ultrasound, MRI diagnosis, timing of total, subtotal hysterectomy, preoperative and postoperative hemoglobin. Conclusion. In summary, cesarean delivery may enhance the incidence of emergency peripartum hysterectomy due to difficulty in the removal of placenta in many cases of placenta previa, usually placenta accreta. Our study depicts that severe postpartum hemorrhage further complex events for emergency peripartum hysterectomy have significant association with placental factors, previous cesarean section, and uterine otony. Pathologically, placenta accreta remain the most leading cause of hysterectomy. In light of severe intractable uterine hemorrhage, hysterectomy is the immediate and unavoidable best treatment. Advice: effective education as well as motivation to reduce abortion rate, as elective abortion is not a contraceptive technique. In primary priority, cesarean section should be fulfilled for absolute indication, a key to minimize placental factors in subsequent pregnancy. Cesarean section on maternal request or for physician convenience should be minimized to avoid associated risk to mother in consequent pregnancy. And finally, timely decision is very important for saving life at the cost of organ removal. And finally, I would like to thank my supervisor and Professor Xiaoyang for your enthusiasm, for your patience, advice, and precious help throughout my study. Without you, it would have been impossible for me to achieve my aim and ambition. And thank you for your guidance. And I would like to thank another professor, Director Qi Hongbo, and Vice Director Zhang Hua, and the Gynecology Director Tang Lao Xu, and jaw lasher, for wu lasher, and fu zhen lasher, linghu lasher, and yuan rui lasher. I'm very thankful to them because I learn every day new technique from them. And I would like to thank my professor, Lo Yun Fong, for introducing millimeter wave therapy for my another study. Because of time limitation, I could not present here. And my utmost gratitude and thanks goes to my Chinese friend who taught me Chinese language and interpret all the Chinese patient records, and I'm thankful to them a lot. And finally, I'd like to thank my father and mother, my husband, and my beautiful daughter. This is my published article and accepted for publication. And I would like to take you to Nepal. This is my hometown. It is a very powerful temple, Kalika, where I was born in this area. And this is a crystal mountain of Pokhara. And it is very beautiful that we can see the heaven and the earth. We can see here the image of the crystal mountain in this lake, which is very beautiful. And for the first time, when I was 7 months gestation, my mother got bleeding and she was diagnosed in this area. And this is my hometown. It is the Mount Dhaulagiri. It is the 7th highest mountain on earth. And I was born in this area despite my mother was diagnosed as placenta previa. And the nursing staff asked my grandmother whom to save, mother or baby. And my grandmother asked her, save both. And I'm thankful to them now that I'm here to standing in front of you and studying the master's degree in obstetric and gynecology so that the knowledge and wisdom I got here would apply in my country people. And this is a Buddhist temple. We believe Buddhism in our country. Kindly visit Nepal. Thank you. This is a third option.
8,000多海拔呀，这个是啊，这个是八千，一百七十，六十多，这么多是八百，去过没有？这个地方我没有去过，但是我天天能看得到这个。哦，天天能看。做的不错，也给我介绍了你们家乡的好文化。这个我们旅游很多很多国外。
中国人还有很多国外的人来这里trekking，欢迎到那边来。我看他做这个还做得很不错，但是我看到有一张片子，他就讲的那个随机对照，你这个研究能做随机对照吗？我就问这一个问题。你觉得如果说你设计能够做随机对照吗？
It is not随机, it's a case control study man. It's a case of control study. In 2000, from 2007 to 2012, there were 36,999 delivery, and among them, there were some preventive methods used, such as uterine packing, billings, embolism. These were used to prevent postpartum hemorrhage. Okay, so I collected from these things, and from this group I select 61 cases of emergency peripartum hysterectomy and studied about it, complication and risk factors.
你这个就是还是以妊娠结局在做研究，一个是做那个急诊剖宫产，因为出血的原因，产后出血的原因做贴子宫，急诊的子宫，哎，回路性的分析，他不可能对去做那个。
因为我看到他有一个专门提的一个说是结婚照，那可能是什么？没有，你吗？这个所有病例都是，不是，最终住院的，住院病例。因为病例上次也有一个学生做过这个子宫切除的，建议，是吧？那么从你总结的，这个要多一些。 那么在你这个做这61例子宫切除当中，你认为就是最首要的？